I should tell you just a little about the concept of what we have done and how this program has developed over past 11 or 12 years. Basically, way back we organized a small exhibition on commercial floriculture, and then what we found that the farmers were coming in and they were looking for, they were primarily were the target of a certain product. Our exhibitors were trying to sell them something. And then most, quite a few of the farmers who were interacting with us, and they said that, okay, we purchased the greenhouses, we purchased everything, but then what? Where do we take our product? Can you arrange? And then this idea came up that we should not make it just a place to sell things, we should make it a place where the interactions take place. So the very next logical step was we organized horticultural plus foodex. That is, companies were requested to come in and source material from the farmers who were displaying what they have produced. There were a lot of linkages. Some of the, now they have developed into farmer produce organizations, quite a few of our cooperative societies, they tied up with the hotel chains and the retailer chains, which were at that time, was a new business, upcoming business. And this network has started going in all the directions. So on the farming front, once we added livestock expo, we had to have a milling expo along with that, because the farmers were saying, we would like to have our own feed production, we would like to have our own grain processing, where to do, where to store, what to do. So this concept developed as a kind of one end is the user, one end is the supplier. So the interaction takes place, the user brings the product, wants the thing, and the buyer tells what he wants. So a food processing company telling the farmer that I want organic product and my specifications are this. The farmers will approach APEDA or the ministry or other authorities concerned and seek the inputs. This is how this whole concept of agri-business exposition, where the grain tech is of course the most important part, because this is one of the largest commodity in the entire bouquet of our exposition or this activity. On behalf of Media Today, I would like to welcome all of you. I welcome Mr. Gokul Patnaik, Chairman Global Agri Systems Limited, who has been our guide and who has been enriching our conferences and telling us the nitty-gritties of the overall picture so that we can come out with better and better solutions to every participant. I would like to welcome Mr. Raghavendra Mailapur, President Karnataka Rural Flour Mills Association of Bangalore. He is also Managing Director of Likith Agro Foods Private Limited. Welcome you, sir. Your presence makes this conference successful in terms of, even if we are expecting a more number of visitors as the exhibition preparation is going on, quite a few participants are yet to arrive. But anyway, it is going to be a very fruitful interaction for the whole day. I welcome Shri Sanjay Dave, former chairman of Codex Commission and advisor to FSSAI of Agribusiness at ITC Group. I should welcome Mr. D.N. Pathak, Executive Director, the Soybean Processor Association of India. He's here. And Mr. Kushwan Jain, Vice Chairman of IOPIA, Indian Oilseed Produce Export Promotion Council. Because I have been associated and we have been writing about them, so it's become a kind of very simple word for me. I always end up calling them IOPIA. It's no more IOPIA. It's now a promotion council. Mr. Kushwan Jain is also owner of GS Exports. I also welcome Mr. Shivkumar, Secretary of Karnataka State Rice Millers Association, and Mr. M.K. Dattaraj, Chairman and Director of Krishna Flour Mills, Bangalore Private Limited. I also welcome, on behalf of organizers, Mr. Prabhu Rajan, member of ASDO, the Silo Developers and Operators Perspective, he will be talking about in the conference. Of course, I welcome all other speakers of the session 3, session 4, and all the participants who have come here, because the people who are making part of this seminar is the speakers who bring in expertise, and of course the ones who are going to interact with the, and use this expertise for the benefit of the nation, for the development of the sector. With this note, I think since we are a bit already late, so I'll conclude and welcome all of you on behalf of the organizers. I also extend my invitation to you to for tomorrow morning, kindly join us at the inauguration of the exposition at Bangalore International Exposition Center. By 10 o'clock, we'll be doing the inauguration. The exposition, we have as a tradition, we normally keep aside the formality of inauguration from the business. They have been in past when the inauguration got delayed. So it's our policy that the work starts at 10 o'clock sharp, no formalities. Even if the VIP is expected delayed, we don't mind. We want you to utilize your time maximum to interact with the people for which you have come. So thank you all, and we welcome all of you. Thank you so much.